Hey folks, Errol over here from Not at Finest, headed several hours down the road to pick up something that is about to join our homestead. So come along and find out what it is. It is. Okay folks, what you're looking at here is our latest livestock addition to our property. After two dogs, two ducks, two cats, and 17 chickens at the moment, plus however many blackies hatching, we added probably somewhere between 10 to 12,000 more creatures here. If you haven't guessed it yet, this is a hive of bees. This is technically called a nucleus. People usually shorten that to nuke, and that's what I just picked up. It's evening. I think it's about to rain, so they're going to be going in that hive you can see behind me. Actually, I've had that hive for a year and a half. I got it the winter before, planning to get bees last summer, and along with all the other things that just didn't happen because we ran out of time, that was one of them. So we are starting with bees this spring. So they are going to, per the advice of the gentleman I got them from, who is operating out of kind of the other corner of Wyoming, gonna let them in here overnight to calm down and recover from their travels, and we're going to try to transfer them into there tomorrow, so you'll see that. But first I'm gonna let them get in and out of this box, and see which end I put the little door at. We'll see how badly I regret not having put on my full bee suit to do this. Now, I haven't kept my own bees before since I've been an adult. I did help my father mostly with his when I was younger, but it has been quite a while, and I have a full bee suit. So if the camera pauses here in a minute and I go adjust my attire, you will know why. But they seem fairly chill, and so I hate wearing extra things like bee hats and veils. And I don't even like trying to untie knots with my gloves on, so we'll see how badly I get myself stung here. But we are going to, these are placed so that opening is approximately where this hive is going to go tomorrow, so they can kind of get used to their location. We're going to talk lots more about bees in the next little while, but they have a pretty amazing GPS. Hi, Zippery. You might not want to sniff them. They're kind of, they can be bitey things to sniff. But they have amazing GPS abilities, and so we want them to get oriented because they obviously just moved many, many miles from where they were living. We want them to get oriented to their new spot that they're gonna be. So let's see if I can open this. There'll probably be a few dead bees in the bottom here that got bruised in the process of the transporting. Hi, meow, I see you. So they're gonna be here overnight, but it is looking like rain, so you probably don't want to sniff them either, Burly. So I think I'm gonna give them a little extra roof out of some plywood scraps there for the night. Yeah, beep beep baby, beep beep. Yeah, this isn't something you want to play with. And put a big rock on top of it just in case we get some of our wind with them, or with a storm. So be as gentle as I can here. So I'm not terrified of getting stung, but I can't say I love being stung. And like I said, we'll talk lots more about honeybees in the next little bit. But our main goal, or mine, this is more my project than Clay's. Not that he's not supportive of it, but he's a little more nervous about bees than I am. Is that I want to have a healthy colony that will hopefully survive the winter here and reproduce itself and take care of itself. And as a secondary thing, I hope that we can eventually start to harvest our own honey so that we have our own sweetener production here on our property. I know you're very curious about what this is about. But you guys might want to give the bees a little bit more space. So get this baggie off of them. There we go. I should have pulled that bag the whole way out before I opened that. If I can continue to stay this close to film Zipper, that might be a bad idea without getting stung. The branches idea is one I've heard other people use. It kind of forces them as they crawl in and out of a spot to have to kind of reset their GPS and pay a little more attention to where they're coming and going from. So hopefully that's helpful with them finding their new spot. Well, I'm gonna go see if I can put a lid on there, which I should have done before I opened that little door. So see how this goes. I'm wanting any bees that are stuck in that bag to be able to find their way out. That's why I opened that up a little.
because there are a few live ones crawling around in there.
So, we're going to leave them alone now for the rest of the night. Come back for the next video to see how successful we are getting them moved into their new hive. Pretty excited about finally having bees. This is something I've been wanting to do, oh, since before I ever even dreamed of moving in a tiny house, actually.
We hope you enjoyed it.
Come back next time for more adventures.
Thanks for watching.